me tell you about my new obsession.
Camera, there we go. Fine. Fujifilm moment. Hello, hello. So it should be in focus. Let me also. Should be good now. I guess we can start. Hello everyone, thank you Andreas for the follow, even though it happened before the stream actually started. Streamlabs decided to actually work for once, so it actually went through in my log chat. Hello, hello, yes, we are back from Clackycon. We saw some boards. Not as much Topper stuff as I would have expected. Thank you for the follow. But nonetheless, still good boards, good vibes. And yeah, a lot of cool people. I finally managed to meet a lot of people that are actually in chat now. So, hi. So, first, the usual. Is the voice okay and is the music okay? Check, because of course, every time I update everything, like the NVIDIA driver, audio levels do whatever they want. Is there music? Yes. I mean, music as in like ambient noise. Okay, so it's very quiet. No music. Huh. One second. I mean, this is the only mic that I have, so brace yourself. What? Okay, it's the only mic that I have. Unless it's like preventing the clip. No, I only have this one. Okay, so I have audio input device. What is this? Properties. What is this? But my voice is coming through. Okay, so that's probably the auto unclip thing. Because this is the only mic that I have. So if I unplug it. Hello, 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 hello. Wait, what? How the fuck? Huh? Okay, this is tripping me. Oh, for fuck's sake, it's coming from the... Wait, no, this is the video capture. Audio capture. Properties. Okay, incredibly high skill issue. What the fuck is going on? Okay, let me check real quick. Okay. Okay. So audio capture is the system volume. Audio output should be the So what about now? Because now it should be this one. So test. Okay, so it was using the camera, even though I have no idea why. Because now the music should be going. But I'm not sure if it is like high or whatever. Okay, so we need to remove this one, because what's going on here? Video capture properties. We don't want to have the audio. The audio is really low now. Test. Okay, what the fuck is going on? Does it clip if I do that? Because I'm not sure. Why the fuck can OBS not keep for once the settings? God fucking damn it. I'm so mad at this. Okay, so audio input device. It's only this one. Yeah, I literally just updated OBS. For fuck's sake. What the fuck? I'm literally on minus 1 dB in the mic. Okay, what about now? Is it better, the voice? At least? Just checking. I'm genuinely mad right now. So audio input is this one now. Yes. So, I guess I can up the gain a little bit. Okay, what about now? Should be better. Just to confirm, if the volume is okay, we can finally move on. Just send a message in the chat. No diff? Holy shit. What the fuck is going on? What the hell? Is this a certified skill issue? Do I really need to buy a new microphone? What about now? Now. Okay, now it's basically at maximum maximum gain. For the microphone. Better? Okay. Way better? Okay, if it's overpowering, just say that. And if you can hear the music in the background, just as a ambient noise, that's good. I literally didn't touch anything from the previous version, so I have no idea what the fuck is going on. Okay, but if this is a normal voice level and it's okay, I'll just use this one. Actually, let me open open Twitch and see if I can listen to myself.
Let me check. Okay, so. Okay, I'm at 50% volume. Let's see. Okay, Andreas, probably that's a U-skill issue, because at 50% on my iPhone, I can hear the... Yeah, sorry for the double. I can hear my voice decently, and I can hear a little bit of the bass music, so I'll just roll with that. and then cope with whatever bullshit is going on for Twitch. Also, check if maybe your player in Twitch has a lower volume, because mine was like normal iPhone level. Okay, so it's good for me, so I guess we'll just roll with that, you know. Okay, so let's first take a look at the board. So this is the Vero R2. It is built currently in the MX form. Yeah, I'm not sure, like, maybe mixer volumes issues, like, no idea. Again, I have no idea, to be honest. Like, I still have to figure out one way to let them, like, stay fixed, and me not having to do anything, and it's still not working. So, probably it's a mix and match, so, yeah. So this is one of the PC prototype case of the R2. It has some differences compared to the final run that the clients will receive. Again, this is MX. We'll be taking out the MX and put in the EC kit that I received literally the day I left for Clackicon. So I was planning to do a sneaky stream the night before I was leaving, but parts didn't arrive in time, and they're about literally like 2 hours after I flew out. So here we go now. We will be using this GMK set, which is GMK whatever. I'm not up to date with the GMK naming scheme, and probably it's gonna be a quite rare set, especially for people that bought stuff from a certain EU vendor. F in the chat for the clients, and definitely not for the vendor. So, yeah. And yes, we are gonna be memeing on and on today for my keyboard, you know, those people. Yes, you know. And also a W in the chat for our gods and savior Oblo, along with basically any other decent human being still up in the EU, namely Jay. From Prototypist. Shout out in the chat. So, PC. This is a pinkish PC. I'm not sure how much it comes through. I should actually do like a white balance check as a reference, but Discord compression, so whatever. Key features. The screws for the case are not threaded into the PC itself, but they have metal inserts, so big W for that. We have a... Let's see if I can show it somehow a very light AKB engraving. Okay, this is the side view. Okay, the back, USB-C, it's centered, the usual stuff. Also, don't mind if you have, like, if you can see, like, inconsistencies and stuff, because, of course, this is a prototype. It was, like, handled quite a bit. So, yeah. So, here, Vero, V2, and Antipode, AKB, and the Antipode logo will be mirrored, as Full is saying in the chat. So for updates on how the production run will actually look like, just check in the chat for messages from Antipode Full. And also, let me drop a link in the chat. Copy text, paste. Okay, the text here is not actually copying properly, so there we go. How heavy? Good question. I'll bring up the scale afterwards. Because, I mean, I can bring it up after we took out the MX stuff, so that we can measure the weight of the case with the back weight and screws and stuff, you know. Definitely too small. Is there only one set weight material? Let's check. So Vero V2 in PC colors, violet and the pinkish one, PCB plate. Yes, there's only one material. Let me check for the material. Okay, so the violet version has a multicolor matte PVD weight, and the pinkish one has a sandblasted and clear coated stainless steel weight. Same gaskets, yes. It uses the same gasket system. And the plate is basically the same outline, but with EC stuff. Also, there are more holes than we need in the plate that I have, because it's one of the prototype plates, and we went through some iterations of that. So some of the holes are not being used. There are quite a bit of plate options for EC, because as you guys know, for EC, the plates are a little bit fucked compared to MX. We can't really do a one plate fits them all kind of deal. But we have normal HHKB, so basically this layout. We have modified HHKB, so basically same layout but with a 2U backspace. And then ISO, which has an ISO enter, a unified backspace, and a split left shift. No, it's not built yet. We are undoing the MX version, because this is what I have now. Okay. Let me grab too small. Just right. Um, This one? No. This one I made it myself. Yeah, this MX stuff is gonna go out. We are gonna be keeping... Thank you for not focusing. We are gonna be keeping just the gaskets. Okay, MX out. And we can take a look at the internals. Not that they are, you know, that interesting. And also, they are definitely not as clean as they should be. Because I didn't have time today to clean them properly. Can Fujifilm, like, keep the focus on something? Okay. There we go. So, this is the back piece. And this is the top piece, where we have the usual AKB Easter egg meme kind of thing. Yeah, you can kind of see it. There we go. Okay. So, we'll move this aside. Yeah, in this case, yes. Because the case was modified for the production runs to actually account for like the additional screws and stuff that we have for EC. Some other projects that they use gaskets, you can still use the same, but the issue with those projects is that the difference in thickness of the plate doesn't give me enough confidence that there is clearance. But in this case, being the case designed from the ground up with EC in mind from the get-go, it's basically working as intended, you know. Okay. Let's move things. Gotta keep the dollar board screws. Definitely not final packaging, as you guys might understand from the bazillion of stuff that I have here. But we have the point. So, plate, PCB. Dodger board, cable, screws, parts, domes, and the usual suspects. Gotta be careful to not knock off the coffee that I have there. Oh my god, stop with the ads, YouTube. There we go. Okay, so We are gonna be using 55 gram domes, KSC springs. We have, for the first time in the channel, the actually fixed stems, because I didn't got any more samples from the prototypes. I mean, they're not prototypes at that point, they were like final release parts before the fix came out. So this is the first time that I'm actually using the fixed ones. And then some other stuff, sinusing rings and all of that. So I guess first we can take a look at the plate, then the PCB, and after that we can then skip to swapping out the stems. So this is the plate, and here is where there are way more holes that we actually need for this build, because that the plate was a prototype, so some holes placement were up to date. So stainless steel, I'm planning to actually try to do some weird stuff with this, namely blow it with a torch and see what finish I can achieve. Okay, here is the PCB. So we have the Antipode logo embedded into the escape key pad, the usual reset and the FU pins. The layout options are the ones that I covered before. We have also a little opening here to have clearance for the JST cable. On the bottom left, instructions for the pads. So briefly shorting the pads will reset the board. Long shorting or using the key code will enter the FU. Then the AKB logo, my logo, and the Vero EC text. So the usual stuff from my PCBs. Okay, so we can now move on. To swapping out the sliders. At the same time, we are gonna be putting on the sinusing rings. No, 55 is totally fine. There's no issues with using 55. So I guess this, I already have one of them swapped out for the non-crown one. I'll swap out the other one too. But I'll not put in the silencing ring yet, simply because I'll have to lube it. So I'll just swap them for now. Okay. There's definitely not enough space on my desk. So I guess we can first put on all the rings. So this is silicone rings, I think. Yes. So we are gonna be using silicone rings. It's been a while since we used them. They are on pretty hard. Yeah, they're not usually my preferred rings. I like them, but I'm more of a super muted sound person, especially because the boards that I use daily are a little bit more like heavy, so I feel like, especially for the HG, even in the case of the BKEs, I want to have a more like dense typing experience, and having a muted sound profile definitely gives me that impression of a more dense board. In a way. So if you want to explore silencing rings options, what you can do is pick up a pack of each measurement for of 0.3, 0.5, and 0.7 of Thok rings. Shipping is insanely cheap and they are very well made. All poron, so no silicone option. For silicone you need to go either to Deskies or Densus. But the Thok rings are definitely a good option. Yeah, usually the consensus is that Densus parts definitely take advantage of a thicker, and I'd say also a poron ring, mainly because the plastic of the housing is a little bit more higher pitched in a way than OEM and also Deskies. I'm not sure if it is the plastic blend. It's definitely the plastic band in my blend, in my opinion. So probably using the silicone rings is not the best of ideas. And actually, while I grab you, Boogie, the link for the Thok rings, people in chat can help me cope and bring out the poron rings. So the link is in the chat, and I think I also have an affiliate code. Affiliate as in you guys have a discount and I get to receive prototypes and stuff before. So this is the extent of the the affiliate part. There's no real money exchange. There are only parts exchange. Thank you, Psych Sora. I think I'm saying it correctly, for the follow. I think I have a code still. I gotta check. Code. Code. I'm trying to do like reverse search in my stuff. Okay, I found the code. So if you guys want to have, I have no idea of how much discount, use the code in the chat. It should still work. Let me check real quick. Checkout. Discount code apply. Yes, it's still working. So if you wanna have Thuck Rings, desk mats and stuff, use the discount code. And yes, so do we wanna do Poron? Yes, we actually do. Sorry, Silicon Sims, but I'm definitely more of a dampened kind of guy. Okay, let me grab the Poron parts. Okay. So we have a choice of 0.7, 0.5. You have 0.5 Thuck Rings, 0.5. There we go. Thank you. And yes. 0.7 for the... the two U's are actually... is actually a very good idea. So we will be doing that. Are there rings left here? No. Nice. And also, I'm not sure those are actually enough. 0.3, 0.5. I don't want to open a new one, you know. Oh, so this is one. This one is used, so we can use that. Nice. Yeah, and I still have like some of the rings that show scent with the original S60. Those were like god awful, way too big. Dampened basically nothing. I have no idea why the menu did such a big diameter hole. Because it's really atrocious. Like, it worked initially, especially when rings were not available, unless you paid like $20 in shipping. But yeah, they weren't that great. Gotta be careful to not lose the ones that I already took out. Good? Yes. Okay. They fit like a glove. Perfect. Do you have any open source EC? Yes, they've been up for a while. As a matter of fact, they've been up so long that China started to clone them. So that's the stage of things. Beware that the license is now more restrictive because of that. It's now a Creative Commons NS something. I mean, clone in a China way, you know. It's not really a clone because it was based on the open source, but then it wasn't really. So let me check the name of the actual license, because I want to get this correctly. Yeah, exactly. Like, it's a great clone as long as you don't want ESD, you don't want RGB parts, you don't want your bulk capacitors for the USB hub or USB ports for that matter. So it is the Creative Commons BYNCSA 4.0, which is basically you can share and adapt the work non-commercially, that is bounding, non-commercially bounding. You can remix the project with a different license, as long as the license is fully compatible with the current one. So something like the GPL V3 would not be an adaptable license, because GPL V3 allows commercial use, and even if the freedoms and duties are the same, the commercial option for GPL V3 will break the compatibility, and therefore avoid breaking the license. So that's the current stage. My GitHub. That's it. (laughs) Oh, what do you search in Mercari? Yes, you just search HHKB and it will pop up like crazy. If you want to buy out options right away, Mercari is the way to go, because that is literally just a buy now option kind of thing. If you want to use Yahoo Auctions Japan, they have buyout prices on some of the auctions. They are usually not that great, or they are at a point where you might just get another board or just try your luck for like a couple of days while the auction is still live to get a proper lowball price. You can pretty much consistently find around the $100 ballpark Pro 2 ANSIs. With Real Force, it's even cheaper. Usually, like old full size non silenced or TKLs, you can find them for around the 85 ish range. Which Real Force, to be honest? Because Real Force has its place, and it might not align 100% with what people describe Topper to be, especially because the plate is quite different, the mounting is quite different. So usually people, when describe Topper, is, I'd say, 80% given by the landing of the slider to the dome sheet, but the remaining percentage is actually the integrated plate in HHKB boards. So that's probably why that was. There are 35, so let's give the count. And to be honest, I'm quite tempted to also start to listen to proper music instead of ambient noise. What I can do is record the VOD. There we go. Take a chick off one look, and when they get took, they don't never get untook. When I seen that body, you would think it was a dead body. The way I told my boys, come look, I used to take girls up the Stony Brook and steal their hearts like some crook. True story. Now when I hold somebody's hand, it's a new story. All my ABGs get too for me. I had one girl, too boring. Two girls, it was cool for me. Three girls, damn, who's horny? Four girls, okay, now you whoring. I'm loose. I done put these songs to good use. I done put my city on my back. In the world, know my name. I'm a true.
There we go. This one is done. Now we gotta pop out the rings. Can I do this like this? Kinda, but it's messy, so let's not do that. I got you playing with yourself on camera. You my bae, just like Tampa. Speaking of bucks, I got those. And as for fucks, well, not those. And as for thoughts, what do you really wanna know? I thought so. I fly you from Korea to Kentucky, and you ain't gotta guarantee me nothing. I just wanna see if I get lucky. I just wanna meet you in the physical and see if you would touch me. The darker ones are the non-twisted ones. So lighter color ones are crooked for the one you. That's why I'm swapping them. They work, but they the stem is crooked. What do you mean by case? You mean the tray? Because if... Oh, you mean the stem. When you purchase from KLC parts, they pack everything, as you can see. So this one with the pre-applied one that were crooked, and then they'll give you a pack with the fixed ones. Reason, repackaging would have cost a bazillion of bucks in time and resources, so they prefer to just ship them out as this, since the deal and full can they should have just hired me to repack them. I cost more than China, probably. Yeah, and that's why I use the screwdriver, because it's the perfect size to not like being stuck between the stem and the slider, but it's not wide enough to like not fit.
Also, there's a tool that you can 3D print to do this and also remove other stuff. It's in the Conical server. Also, I think I miscalculated the number of parts. I should probably remove two housings and sliders because two are the enter and the shift. So we shouldn't need those, technically. So it should be actually 12, so like this, this number, yeah. Thank you for the ads. Let's skip them. There we go. Okay. Plate. So let's get this in the right orientation. So this is the top. So this is the bottom. There you go, I've provided you with 2-day sick leave. Hopefully paid ones. Stay by my side when the nightmare goes. I've been feeling distant, just way out of control. I'm not really sure how the sick days work over there. Double pay when you're sick. There you go. I just provided you with double pay. You can let me know the total of the doubling amount and I'll invoice it to you later today after the stream. It's the pain that we have to endure to have the thought. Thinking that way. Mm-hmm. More ads, thank you. Yeah, but the issue is, I use Chrome because I'm a basic bitch. I don't use all of those super things that people use because I'm literally just too lazy to set them up. archiving this after? Yes. So probably parts of the audio will be muted on Twitch because of copyright, of course. But the video is gonna be up, so. Yeah, I mean, we are back to the same point that I made before. I'm very basic. I should either record locally without the music as a separate audio track and all of that. But again, I'm too lazy. I stream once a month, if anything. And also, I try to almost done with the one use. And let's catch the ads before they come. There we go. And of course we have two more because I miscounted. Goes here. Okay. And this other one goes here. Let me grab my lubing stuff. Be right back. There we go. Mm-hmm. Gloves. That's a scary box, yes. And it's a box that is almost empty. Because I was counting on restocking my lube with new lube whenever the dampening mat was available. But it's not yet. So we will be running a very light amount of lube. So if there is any ticking from the wires, that's the reason. Because I have literally like counted drops of them. Bye bye, Boogie. Have a good one. So, what we'll do is use the one on the lid to do my usual lubing of the housing. So basically the sides. Again, we don't need that much for this part of the process. Let's put in the ring. we go, another Adobe ad, nice. Gotta love that. Let's check from the top. Yeah, should be good. Whoa. Nice. That's a new one. Let's try and add the usual lube to the clips. Not that much, because again, we don't have that much to work with. Overall, nice new ad. There we go. Okay. Let's do lightly the housing in the middle.
Talking high and low. For a man who's just right. And treats me mighty fine. So come on, baby.
Okay, should be almost done.
Okay, clean them up.
Yeah, nice. Yet another ad. Nice. Okay. Let's clean the brush. Okay, nice. Let's already prepare the band-aids for the PCB. Let's put the lube stuff away. One last piece. There we go. As a reminder, the reason why I'm doing this band-aid thing is basically to use it as a landing zone for the spacebar stems. New YouTube ad incoming. Let's skip this. There we go. And I basically just stick it right under the spacebar area where the stabilizer housing would be. Like this. That's ban slash ban remove the spacebar. Yes. That's one way of saying it. Remove the spacebar. Mm-hmm. That's a new way of saying it for the bots. Nice jokes, guys. They are upping their game. Yeah, I have a backup. I have OEM 45 in strips. Not sure if they are enough. We'll see. And yes, I've suggested them to do strips or full set for the next batch whenever they're gonna order more. Yeah, I mean, it was just to have them centered, kinda, because then I have to, like, level the springs, so it was just a first pass, you know. And yes, I'm about to cope. I'm about to cope, guys. Yes. So let me marinate a little bit while I decide if I'm full blown coping or not. Man, I hate hats. God damn. Also, why are, like, all going off now? Like, god damn. This one's brain. No, it's two. Huh? Oh, wrong way. This is what we get for people wanting MX on Topper. Dad, can we have Topper at home? Son, we already have Topper at home. Topper at home. I was expecting someone to do like some kind of Linux joke, and I use Arch, by the way, at the meetup. No one made that joke. I was actually genuinely surprised. Like, a lot. What's the difference between a board that provides both and one that is EC only? What do you mean? As in, if the board, as like the keyboard, provides both options. Or you mean like the stem, like that kind of thing? Oh no, I was just memeing. I love to meme and complain for nothing just to let time pass. Oh, hi Pontus. Hope you're having a good day. Well, actually, you had a good day because it's basically over. Okay, big brain time. Let's just align them correctly, as in facing the right direction, and then we'll use the PCB to level them in one go. This is a big brain moment. Let's hope it works. Oh? We have a spring that decided to marry the PCB. And it kind of worked. You know? It kind of worked. I gotta say. We are pretty good. So now it begins the little doctor game. Can someone sponsor me to go in China? Please. Good night. The vault will be up down the line. So if you wanna check out the rest of the build, just refer to the VOD. And I was 100% serious. If someone wants to sponsor me to go to China and open a company there that does EC parts without the sassy stuff that some China stuff provide now, let me know. I have a passport so I can travel without any issue. Or any Southeast Asia, to be honest. Okay, pretty good, you know, I gotta say. The screw gap between the housings. What do you mean? The screw gap? It's probably the domes, because I shaved off a little bit to the side, so that's why it seems like, for example, here, the gap is way bigger than here. So that, if that's what you, what you're referring to. Let's zoom in, so you'll see that the dome is trimmed just a little bit. Yeah, pretty good, I gotta say at this point. Okay, now screws. Let's take off the ads. Okay, let's also check that this crew bit is the correct one before. Yes, it is. So now, critical ones to use. Okay, coffee, and then we are off to the races. Let's see if I can use, actually, no, probably not. I'll just align it. So sorry for my big ass head. So I'll drop some screws here and there so that pretty much the alignment stays the same, and then I'll start to tighten down. Also, based playlist so far. Okay, pressing down in the middle, screwing the 2U, then this one, then going here, 2U again. I gotta check this, because it's one of the ones that I tapped myself, so it's a little bit scuffed right now. But of course the production run ones are gonna be, of course, completely fine. Did I tap to this crew? I think I did. And I can probably just skip it just to avoid it being saucy. And also there's enough compression, so. Oh, we have missed one screw here. Now I'm checking that the screw head are flush. Okay, this one can go a little bit higher. Okay, definitely too much lube. God damn it. Fucking hell. Yeah, especially like with me trying to spare the lube, but not correctly sparing it. Because I just went to it without too much thought about it. God damn it. Let's remove the gaskets so I don't lose them. First of all, I want to check if... Yeah, we are doing strong, you know? It's going great, I gotta say. Okay, so this tap that I did is garbage. So, first skill issue of the day from me. Second of all, second skill issue, this one. This is a higher skill issue than I want to admit. So the trick is to loosen the screws from the neighboring area. Try to separate plate and the PCB assembly a little bit. And hopefully it will self-align. And if not, I cry. Holy fucking shit. Why is this one good and this one doesn't? Isn't, actually. I'm so mad right now. Okay, you know what? I'll just leave it as it is, because from a functional standpoint, it's gonna be fine. and I'll just fix it later. That's what I'm gonna do. Yeah. So.
Searching for the best SFX for your video.
Oh my god, stop with the ads, man. Give me like 5 songs without ads. Thank you. What is this? Okay, perfect. There we go. Nice. Caps, I guess. Yes, caps. Spring on the left. No, that's, it's not GMK in this case, it's me being skill issued and not aligning the dome properly, but still. Also, speaking of GMK, GMK, whatever the name of the set that I bought is, for sale. DM me if interested. Dolge? GMK Nord Dolge. There we go. DM me if interested. Still boxed. Used once to take pictures in the box. I've eaten a bit of the tray because GMK memes, but totally worth it. DM me if interested. I'm desperate. I need to sell stuff, please. I sound an awful lot as Simon. I'm not in that big of a situation. But yes, buy my GMK set, please. Works. Search. It's on the Oblo website. GMK Nord Doge. So NORRDE. And then Doge, you know, the normal stuff. Not modified, not drilled, not anything. Okay. I'll pre-bend a little bit JST so that it comes off at an angle. There we go. Actually, I'm dumb as fuck, because I could have sold it at the meetup. I'm dumb. I could have totally found someone that, you know, would have wanted to buy it. Oh, I'm a big dumb. Certified dumb, yes. Yes, it's the same. I've swapped it. From the one that was in before, simply because that one was an early version that had the JST a little bit more forward, as in like towards the PCB, and that one didn't clear out as well as this one. So let me remove the ad. Okay, so you'll see how it's very close and tight. There is clearance now. But on the previous one, the JST connector was slightly towards the PCB and that did not clear out. So this is why I swapped it. But beware that this new revision, the daughterboard, will be used regardless of MX or EC. It's the one that will be shipped with the board. Okay. So now I gotta be careful. It's a modified version of the unified daughterboard. Like the specs are the same, but it's not a unified daughterboard. Mainly because it's the unified is too wide. Even if the unified is pretty small by the normal standards, like the S version. And also a thing that I did is adding this clear out like semicircle cut so that the dome is still there but you can route the cables like this. Okay, now let me take the bottom case. And I'm gonna do it in a sussy way. So I'll drop the bottom case on the top. Main reason is that otherwise it will pop out, and also you are already in the correct orientation. So longer screws. What do you mean? It's off-centered. The USB is centered. To the case. So I'm not sure what's not off-centered. USB port on a PCB. I mean, it makes sense to for it to be off-centered. Mainly because why would you add symmetrical FR4 on the other side when you don't actually need it, you know? Will it be available over the years? Yes, I think. They will be probably using it in other projects. And they, by they, I mean Antipode, Fall in chat, if he's still in chat, can confirm that, will confirm that. But we will have like plenty of extras and stuff, so like there's no, don't worry, it will not go away, you know. Even if it's a slightly custom implementation, if something happens, you'll be able to have replacements. It's not gonna be a, hey, we lost the files, or, you know. That will not happen. Also, on the subject of this case being a prototype, a thing that was noted on the IC, and that those of you that paid attention might have noticed already, there is no central screw. So the reason for the addition of the central screw is that we've noticed that PC bows quite a bit. You'll see. So what we ended up doing, and by we I mean I noticed the issue and James proceeded to amend the case design, is that the PC version, and only the PC version, has a center screw to basically keep the case properly sealed. And this is why, if you purchase the PC version of the case, for EC, you must use a KLC wire. That is because the bends that it has allows you to have clearance for that extra screw. If you instead have purchased a ALU version of the Vero, you can use either the OEM style wire, so like the straight one, or the KLC. If you try to use the straight wire slash OEM style in the PC, it will not work. It will not fit. Main reason, because then it will not actually be able to do it. Yeah, like, it's not that we custom made the wire for the PC version. I just realized that, hey, there is this possibility. The wire is widely available. The stab kit from KLC is actually quite good once you properly tune it. So it's a good addition, in my opinion. It's a good option for what we're gonna do, basically. Thank you, Alpha, for the follow. Yeah, also, I don't know if you noticed, if you saw the announcement, but the S98, so like the 980 PC version, will not go forward because the walls are too thin. So there's an issue there. Okay, so case closed. This one returns, kinda. Okay. Okay, no weird domes apart from this. All the domes return correctly. Nice. So let me clear out. All the parts. Yeah, if only PFU sent me keycaps, you know, or if they made them available for purchase in Europe, even though, let's be real, they're gonna be $96, so fuck that. Actually, let me find Via. Okay, let's move to Via. Okay, so now I have this one. We'll unplug the HG. And plug in. I can't reach with this one. I gotta use the other cable. Okay. Windows sound. Authorize. Okay, let's change right away. Backspace. Delete. Easy tools, just because I don't know if this is cleared. Let's do the bottoming. Oh, left shift is doing the funny. Oh man, we have the funny moment. Did I actually put on springs in there? I think I have. Oh man. Am I about to go banana? Yes, I'm about to go banana. I wanna die. My springs are fucked. Do you have the bin? Because I can reflash. The bin that you said was right. Let me find a keycap puller. Actually, no, not needed. I'll do this. I can do it. You're in bed? Oh, come on. You can do it. I believe in you. Wait, okay, so it's the one that I sent you, right? But which one is the question? Okay, so if it's working, that'd be fine. So, was it the test ABCD, the one that I sent you? Probably. Okay, let's test the ABCD. Thank you, Discord. Valid response. Wait, what? What are you saying? One second. Let me open my laptop. Let's do some math. Can I even send? Yeah, probably. Stand by. We are trying to find the correct bin. I mean, it's whatever. I'm on a different laptop, so no worries about leaking stuff. Let me find that one. Unless it's a certified Chrome moment. Okay, I'm recompiling a firmware to see if stuff will happen. Stand by. It might be a me using a older firmware skill issue. Let me doing live only, 'cause now we might actually leak stuff. So one second. No wireless board struggle. Okay, let's see if with this one we are more in luck. Okay, certified old firmware moment. Because now I reflash with another one. Test matrix reset. You can see that I reflash because delete is back to delete and not backspace. Okay, it works. Nice. So you'll be now seeing things that never happen usually, which is me fixing a PR that I have opened. This will be live. We're doing it live. So let's push this commit. Fix. Actually, it's not a fix, it's more of an adjustment. Okay, adjustment, actual value. Yes, it's doing its thing because it's GMK, and I would like to say fuck GMK, but they have been kind of based by putting out this statement against my keyboard, so I'll give them a pass for today, but only for today. So we'll commit this one to my repo, sync the changes, and then go back to my PR to the Vero. It should be still up. Yes, it's still up because no one watches my PRs. Thank you. Put it to 50 and then do this, commit, and then send it. Just because, let's be the nice folks that also change the value here, and let's apply this to sync the changes, and I'll do the same on my other branch. Commit and sync. We are done. Okay. So, because I'm a good guy, I'm also gonna be updating so gmake j cplot ec vero via and Virgo, so we're updating the firmwares on my upstream. You guys are seeing like an insight into what it looks like, my chaos that I usually have. So we have here two firmware files. Usually I would mass erase my prefix name, but I'm gonna do it in the UI. So this one goes here. We will go back in firmware and go in the Virgo one and update that one too. Upload. Okay, just for safekeeping. I'm also gonna update my personal repos. So here, showing folder, replace, and update, commit, push, showing folder, replace, commit, push. UI, yes. It's disgusting, but it was already open. And also, I don't want to navigate into 75 subfolders. Let's also do good documentation by going into the changelog. Okay? Because changelogs are important. changelog. Add, today is the 11th of April 2024, and the point being that here we have a tweak of internal should value for calibration for the following boards. Double, EC Vero, and EC Virgo. There we go, nice. Save, close, we're done. Quit, 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 close, there we go. Nice. Okay. Crisis averted. We have now a working keyboard. Let's change the view. So there we go. It's just because I don't have any keyboard that will actually fit. okay, so let's zoom in a little bit. Okay. So this is how the board looks like. Good thing about this board is that you have access to the reset and DFU button if you ever need to, because there is an opening under the control key. Okay. So this is how it looks like. And the nice thing is that being slightly transparent, I mean, it's dyed, so like it's colored PC, you can see the AKB logo and my logo and kind of the instructions, but not really critical, to be honest. But you can also kind of see the components. Very nice stuff, you know. Let's see. Can I shine it to at an angle? Oh, it's way too bright. I mean, you can kind of see, you know. Actually, in the stream, it's actually more clear than in person. You can definitely make up the words and stuff. So, very interesting. You can kind of see also the dollar board. To an extent, but yeah, the result is very nice. Very nice. What keycap did I use? No idea, to be honest. It's a GMK set that I know, but beyond that, really not. I have no idea of what keycap set this is. We can try and see, is there like a database of GMK stuff? Yes and no. So usually yes. In this particular case, this is me bottoming out. Can be better, of course, but GMK, you know, and the EC parts. So what you can do is actually shave off a little bit the side of the housing. Showplate sheets will improve this to an extent because you're simply preventing the true bottom out. So I think that if you shave off the front edge of the housing a little bit, and you use the show mat, you will have a much better experience, I'd say. Remember though, that if you mount anything that changes the travel, it being sanitary rings, the mat, or whatever, either use that, like mount the board with that from the get-go and do the calibration with that, or if you use it like this, let's say, as I'm doing right now, and then I decide to mount the mat that Shell provides, remember to redo the calibration. Does it fit on top of the MacBook? Let me check. So, 14 inch for reference. So this is where the fifth align. So technically speaking, half of the fifth actually go where the speaker grill is, but I think it's too short. So like the distance between the fit is too short to go over the keyboard size, so it will definitely touch. It will definitely touch the keys. So just as a reference, this is how it would look like. But I think I'm actually, I would say if you center it properly, you might get away with it. You know? I'm gonna open the test text. And find a cable. Actually, you know what I can use? I can use the PUX that I 3D printed. This is basically a replica of the official ones. So you basically place them in between the keys. And they provide a surface. This cable is not the best one, to be honest, because it will touch the screen. Do I have another cable? I should. There we go. So the issue with the PUX is that they raised the board, so it's not leveled anymore with the keyboard. But they work. And it works. So if you use the cable that comes with the iPhone 15 lineup, you have enough clearance and it's actually looking quite good. Not bad. I gotta say, not bad. So, you know, right, this is macOS now, so windows and thing are inverted. So you know what we can do? Let's switch camera. Okay, we are in conical now. No leaking. So, Ohio there. This message was written using the Vero R2EC in the PC case on actually while sitting on my Mac using the PUX. Thok. There we go. EC with ALU versus EC with PC. So there are really not that many PC cases that do EC. Main reason is that those who actually did it had issues with manufacturing. Issues such as the case walls are too thin. As an example, the S90 that Sho is making might not have a PC version because the walls are too thin. Making PC is very difficult, like extremely difficult compared to ALU. ALU is basically doing 2+2. PC is quite a bit more involving from a manufacturing standpoint, and also the rejection rate is way higher, because with PC you can't really justify scratches or marks that with ALU you could do. The Vero actually has very thin walls, especially because of how the top case is made. You'll see that, and you can probably see that also in earlier in the stream, if you've been here at the beginning. This sidewall is actually part of the top case, so you'll see here in the matching line, this is the outer edge and this is the bottom case. So this is probably the thinnest slice of PC that I've ever seen, and it goes quite a bit deep. So like, it's this deep, it goes from here. Fuji, thank you. Okay, it goes from here all the way to this part, because then from this part onwards is actually the edge. Okay, so this is actually very straight for being PC that thin. The issue with PC is also that on longer pieces it warps, or it tends to bow after you apply pressure. And it's the case with this prototype unit. The top piece doesn't actually match with the bottom, and that's why the production runs units, the one that you guys will receive, have an extra screw, and that's why we have the need to use the other spacebar wire. So that's the reasoning behind it. From a sound point of view, I'd say they're not really the same. They're different. I would have to have two of the same case design side by side to really get into differences, because I feel like the differences that I could like put out that I've noticed are much due about the because of the design of the case in general, rather than the material itself. Because some case designs makes no sense, but they work. Kind of like the S60, the original one was basically empty air for 50% of the internals, but it was so deep sounding that was incredible. And same goes for PC in other designs. It really depends on the case design, I gotta say, at this stage. People with boards that have both options and they have both units might have a more deeper insight into that. So for that, I'd advise you to maybe ask Jason, because I think he has a PC version and an auto version of the same board. So probably worth asking in Conical for that. Thank you, Andreas, for stopping by. Hope you enjoyed the build. And I'll see you in Conical, waiting for updates on the keycaps. Have a good one. Okay. So it's now time to check the stuff that you can get for the Vero R2. Let me grab the link and we'll go through it. Okay, so once again, here's the link in chat. So there's, again, auto version, PC version, and then mystery color PC. It's a mystery, so even if you ask me which color it is, I don't know, because it's a mystery. And even I don't know what the color is. Options. For the plate, we have stainless steel as the option for the EC plates. Reason, it's stiff, threads last forever. So that was the reason. Layout options, we have normal HHKB, so split right shift and split backspace, ANSI, of course. Then we have a modified ANSI, which is split right shift and full backspace. And lastly, we have ISO with split left shift, right shift is splitted, and we have the unified backspace. Here it goes beyond. So you'll have to check the picture. There you go. So ISO, full backspace, and split. We've decided to not have unified right shift because on an HHKB it does not make sense. First of all, you have access to these two keys as like layers, but then you defeat the purpose of having the diamond shaped arrow keys and all of that. I didn't want that. So split is always there. The PCB supports unified backspace, unified right shift. So if you want to use it for whatever reason, we'll think about making the plate, the DXF for that, so that you can produce it yourself if you really want to. I was reluctant in including ISO, but then people said, hey, people really want ISO. And then I thought about you, Pontus, and I said, okay, I'm going to do it. So allo. We have three options, Demi Void, then Luna, which is a two-tone, so silver top, red bottom, and then Fool's Gold, a very nice color. This is the back of the red version. And this is the back of the void. Very cool options. Again, you can decide between EC or MX. Then the plate. You have a bazillion of options for MX. And then the ones that we basically listed before for EC. The PC version of the case is either the pinkish version, which is this one, or violet with a PVD finish weight. The finish for the pink version is silver. So beware that based on which color you have, the weight option changes. Again, EC, MX, and then again, usual plates. You can purchase parts, the KLC parts that you've seen now. Again, you'll receive also the fixed stems. So don't worry about not receiving them. You'll get them. There's domes, there are springs, silencing rings, silicone and poron. So you can make your choice between the two. And then that's pretty much it. You can buy extra stuff like gaskets and feeds and stuff. The usual spare stuff. Keyboard bag, if you want one. With removal internal parts. So, quite a lot of options, you know? Quite a lot of options. For the MX aficionados, there's MX stuff. We don't care about it. And then there's the EC PCB, which is the final one. The one that you saw during the stream build is the final one. That is what you guys will receive. So black finish with the silver accents for like the Vero EC logo, my logo, AKB's logo, all of that. So the PCB is final, the plate material is finalized. You'll not have the bazillion of extra holes that I showed you guys. That is purely because it was a prototype, so bear that in mind. Okay, so once again, this was the... Let's go 35, 33. This is the Vero R2 in the EC variant. Silver PC. Doing another full tour. Okay, once again, this is the back. Bear in mind that here you'll have another screw for the PC version and no screw for the Alu version because of the PC material nature. So that's what the extra screw fixes, basically. Because it's PC, PC bows on longer distances. So this is why an extra screw here is important to keep everything tight and sealed properly. Doesn't really impact that much the usability, if at all, because there's no issues in using it right now. But of course, because this is a product that is sold to customers, this is really not acceptable, and that's why we have the extra screw. There we go. Honestly, I thought it would be cheaper. I don't make the prices. that's all I can say about the pricing, to be honest. I'm only the PCB guy. I don't do the product decision making stuff. So for that, I'll have to redirect you to full and the rest of the Antipode team, to be honest. I'm not involved in the pricing and price point setting for the products that include my PCBs, so I can't really say much about it. So, reminder of the dates. Okay, the group buy opened on April 5th and it will stay open until the 26th of April. So you have plenty of time. Maximum unit 150 available for purchase. The group buy will close early if the unit count is reached before the end date. So keep that in mind. I'll post the final date and other info in the chat. And once again, this is the product page. Okay, I think we basically covered everything in the build process. As you saw, pretty much the same as usual for EC. The only thing that I would consider doing is, because the openings for the gaskets are on the top case, you have to think about mounting the board upside down, really. So you would basically raise the top case upside down as you would with the PC, the EC plates, then drop in the plate PCB parts assembly with the gaskets so that it sits properly in the top case, and then very carefully drop the bottom on top and then screw it in. Because if you try to like keep it squished so that the internals don't fall off from the top case, you'll end up with the PC especially bending the PC or introducing bends that then either damage the board or simply don't allow you to properly fit it, because the fitment is very precise for the PC all around. So if you try to squish it to avoid stuff falling off, then you'll end up simply not being able to mount it properly, like inserting the two pieces and matching them properly. Yeah, so that's probably the only advice that I would give. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. So if you guys have any questions, just let me know. Because if not, we'll see if someone is live on Twitch doing keyboards. Keyboards. Who is doing keyboards? No one is doing keyboards. Nice. Okay, so I guess we are not raiding anyone today. Yeah. Okay. That's pretty much it for today, guys. Thank you everyone who joined. The VOD will be live basically right now. I'll probably have to manually publish it because of the songs being played. So audio probably cut. Whatever, the actual important bits are the visual side of things. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Again, thank you, James, for designing the board. I know HHKB is not his usual layout that he likes to rock, but I really appreciate the fact that he took on the effort to support EC, given that it's a true HHKB. And also thank you, the Enfo team, for allowing me to work on the EC version and collaborate with them also on the Virgo. I'm not sure we'll have a Virgo build. Probably not. But the build process is kind of the same. It's gasket mounted too. The only difference is that it's bigger. but yeah, the basic concept is basically the same. We'll see if maybe a stream is arrangeable, or if we will just point to one of my streams. Oh, Opus is live doing keyboards? Hell yeah. Why is it not popping up? Oh, building another board by AKB? Hell yeah. So we are definitely raiding Opus.
Just because James says he thinks the gaskets should go somewhere doesn't mean you have to do that. That's the beauty of the custom keyboard.
Why is he bashing?
If you want to put a gasket here, you can, right?
On
but
James.
I guess the designer's vision is to not put a gasket here.
MSG.
That's the top, you know, pretty simple.
Raid message. What is the command? Raid message? Yes. Okay. So we are going to be raiding Opus. Show him love. And yeah. Thank you again, everyone who joined. And I'll see you next time. Hopefully in less than 6 months for the next stream. Bye.
Plate. And I mean, there are a few differences, right? I think oh no, they're the same. They're pretty much the same. Oh, hey, Sipulot. Thanks for the raid.